Hey guys, what's up and welcome back to my channel. Thank you so much for being here. Thank you for taking the time out and watching this video. Firstly, I want to say thank you so much for your comments on my previous video. Like, it blew my mind. I was so touched by seeing your responses, by seeing how you guys interacted with each other in the comment section down below. And I was really excited. I was up till 3-4 o'clock the other day just responding to all your comments, and I was having so much fun. Also, I was so touched by all the stories you guys were sharing online and on a public platform, so I really appreciate you. Thank you so much for having the courage to tell me your story. That means a lot to me, and yeah, I just wanted to take the time to tell you that I appreciate you and I love you, and you've made this already successful. I don't care about the views, I don't care, I don't see it. I just go to the comment section down below and I just see what you guys have to say. Okay, that's all that matters to me, and so I want to say thank you so much, okay? So in today's video, I'm going to be talking about how to find your path, okay? It's a super exciting video. I'm going to fuel your fire once again, and I'm going to give you the motivation to start your week amazingly well tomorrow, okay? So over the years, I've gotten so many DMs from you, so many emails from you asking me, Miles, how did you find your path? Like, how did you know YouTube was your career? How did you turn your passion, that is makeup, into your career? And also how lost some of you were and how you were not happy with your job. You just wanted to quit and you wanted to start something of your own, but you didn't have the courage to do so. You just want to know why and how, okay? And I'm here to just like give you a head start. I want to give you like a few points that I noted down. I was watching Rachel Hollis and Jay Shetty on how to achieve your goals, finding your path, your purpose. These two people were key for me in making this video. So I pulled out points from each of their videos and I clubbed it with my thoughts and my vision and how I want to put this across to you. So that's what we're gonna do, okay? So grab some food and relax with me, because it's gonna be a chit-chat video. Again, it's gonna be just me talking to you. You can take down notes. Oh my God, I saw you guys taking pictures and sending it to me of you noting the things down. This incredible. I can't believe you're noting what I'm saying down. It's amazing. It's amazing. So firstly, tell me how you guys doing. Like, what's up? What's happening with your self-love progress? I know it's only been a week, but fill me in. Let me know down below, like, where are you in your journey already? What have you been doing over the past week? I would love to know all that, okay, before we start the activities of today's video. So I hope it's going awesome for you. I hope you're doing the things that you really need to enrich your body, mind, and soul, and you're on your way to achieving self-love, okay? That's all I want. So I really hope you guys are continuing this. It's an ongoing process. It's not something that happens overnight, so please continue with your process and you will get there soon. Firstly, let me break down what dreams, goals, and purpose is, okay? So take dreams for example, okay? So dreams are something we think a lot about. We visualize a lot, okay? We spend most of our time dreaming, right? So example, my dream is to become Deepika Padukone. I want to be like a very successful actress, okay? Hypothetically. Now, I'm going to convert that into my goal. Okay, and what I've done is basically I'm going to start paving a way to achieve it. That's when it becomes my goal, okay? That's actionable. So what do I need to become a successful actor, right? First, I need to take some headshots, okay? Then I need to start going to auditions. Then I need to start networking with people around me. I need to see who are my other actor friends who can help me out with auditions. I'm going to start taking like Hindi classes, Urdu classes. I'm going to start taking acting classes. I'm going to start assisting in a movie. Like, these are some things you can do to sort of pave your way through the industry, correct? So automatically your dream of becoming an actress converts into goals, and now they're actionable because you have sort of paved a way. You have made steps. That's when you sort of achieve your dream, okay? So those are your dreams. So of course we have millions of dreams. We keep dreaming about the tiniest little things, okay? Someday I want to have this, someday I want to have kids. That could be a dream, okay? But you can't just dream about things. You can't just let it be a dream. You got to convert it into your goal and you're going to start working towards it, okay? That's when you can put in your hours and you can actually achieve it in this lifetime. Okay, and it may take months, it may take years, but at least you're moving forward and you're working towards it, okay? And so that is dreams and that is goals. Now, what is purpose? Okay, so purpose is something I believe in my understanding. Okay, purpose is something we're all looking for. When you sort of reach this stage of self-love, when you are more self-aware, where you spend time with yourself, you meditated, you attain this stage in life where you are in the midst of living your dream. Okay, like I am, I would like to say that I am in the middle of living my dream. I'm waking up with so much of excitement every single day to do my job. Okay, and so for me, that is living my dream, and I was living it. But I came to a point in my life like a few weeks ago where I was like, well, I'm living my dream, I'm happy, but I need to find something else. That's when I started realizing that I needed to look for my why. Okay, and what is your why? It's your reason for waking up every single day in the morning. And the reason why you can't wait to go to bed just to wake up in the morning, okay? So you need to find your why. So yeah, I want to build a channel. I want to build a very successful beauty community and, you know, put out content. And that's what I want, like, that's my dream. But a few weeks ago, I realized that I wanted to use my dream and my passion in service of other people, which is this video and this playlist. I want to use this platform to sort of be of service to you guys. I want to help you. I want to sort of help you in personal development and make you like an amazing, strong, independent woman or boy, right? So that is my purpose. I want to convert my time. I want to use my platform to be of service. So for me, that is my purpose. I feel like that is my purpose, and it gives me the satisfaction. It fulfills me in a way. Like, I wake up every day wanting to learn something new just so I could tell you guys and just so I could help you. All right, so I hope I help you understand the difference between dream, goal, and purpose, because it's really important to know where you are at in life. Are you just dreaming about things and not doing anything about it? It's not enough. Are you putting your dreams into your goals? Amazing. Are you working towards it? Even more amazing. Once you reach your goal, you will then convert your dreams and your goal into your purpose. Okay, you will convert your passion into purpose, and you will find whatever your purpose is. Now, I'm not going to tell you what that is, because you got to find it yourself. Okay, now I want to say, no matter who you are, man, no matter what age you are, you have a purpose, okay? And you gotta find that. And no matter what age you are, your dreams are valid. It doesn't matter if you're a mom, if you're 19, 13, 65, 40, it does not matter, okay? Someday we're all gonna be in that stage where, you know what, I wanna do something more with my life. I wanna build it up more. Just because I'm a mom, just because I have kids, it doesn't mean that I have to stop my dreams, okay? So I wanna tell you that whoever's watching, whatever age, if your mom's watching, I want you to look at her and tell her, mom, it's not too late. You can still do whatever you wish, you can still do whatever you're dreaming of, and you have been dreaming of ever since you were a little girl, but you got married really soon and you didn't get to live your dream. Okay, I want you to tell her that it's still valid, and you're gonna help your mom achieve her dream if that's what it takes. Okay, a lot of us may have a lot of things we like to do. We like to cook, we like to play music, we love adventure, but we don't know what is that one part that is pulling us the most. Okay, and if also you're someone that who is completely lost and has no idea, you're in the middle of summer vacations, you're like, when am I gonna intern? I have no freaking clue what I'm gonna do with my life, and it's freaking me out. Okay, I don't know where I'm gonna get my money from, how am I gonna live. Okay, I know you're freaked out right now, but I need you to like brace yourselves. It's okay to be lost no matter what age you are. It's okay to not have a dream and goal. It is absolutely fine. You just need to start taking steps to find that, okay? And that's something you gotta do yourself, okay? Now, I want you to go back to your childhood and think properly. What is something that fueled your fire? What is something that made your eyes twinkle? Like, did you love arts and crafts? Did you love painting a lot? Like, did that make you happy? Did you love Legos? Did you love building stuff? Did you love cooking with your mom? Like, what is one thing that completely excited you when you were a kid? Okay, you can sort of go back to your little you and find what made you happy, and that could be your passion, that could be your calling. But then life got in the way and you completely forgot that, right? But try and go back. And I want to tell you one thing that I know most of you realize that, Maz, but my passion will not pay my bills. Like, you know, that's what I thought. I'm like, YouTube and makeup is not going to pay my bills. I need to go out and work. I was so wrong. I could not be more wrong. Okay, makeup was my passion, and I did it even though it didn't pay me. So your passion does not have to pay you in the beginning, okay? It does not have to pay you, and it's okay to have a dream that doesn't pay you. That doesn't mean it's not valid. That doesn't mean that's not your dream. It still is your dream. It's still valid. All you gotta do is give it your hours. You need to put in your hours. You need to put in the hard work, and you need to be consistent at what you're doing, okay? If what I loved was makeup, I consistently uploaded videos, I played with makeup, it didn't pay me shit. I didn't get any money for the first few months or even like a year at least. I kept on putting content, and I was just doing it for the love of it because I love putting makeup on. And I did not think that it had to pay me, okay? It's not the idea I went in with. But then somehow it started rewarding me and I started getting recognized, ABC, and this is where I'm at today. Make sure you are mastering your craft, whatever that may be, cooking, building a business, learning a new language, it can be anything, okay? You need to be really, really good at it. You need to study your craft and you need to be amazing at it. And it may not pay you at all for the first, because you're still learning, right? But until that happens, you need to continuously do it, and you will find that it keeps making you happy. You will wake up every single day wanting to go to art class, wanting to go to dance class, wanting to learn a new language just so you can be a teacher someday. You have to know that this is where you want to be. You can't just do a job because you want an income and this is just what you'll do for the rest of your life, and you'll put your dream on a backseat. Like, it's gonna take a toll on you and you're gonna resent it. 10, 15 years down the line, just picture yourself, okay? Just picture yourself, you're 40 years old. Okay, you're 40 years old, you look back, and where do you see yourself? Like, what do you see yourself doing? What would I have loved to do? If I was 80 today, what would I have loved to do? Would I have loved to open a dance academy? Would I have loved to produce movies? Would I have loved to be an astronaut, an engineer? Whatever that may be, man, it should be your passion and your dream and your story to tell. If you're really still confused, I want you to ask your family, ask your friends, the most important 5 people of your life. I want you to ask them, like, what do you think I should do? Like, what do you think I'm good at? Like, sometimes listening to other people around you who love you so much and who know you inside out. You know, we have those 5-6 people who just know us inside out better than we do. I want you to ask them, like, what do you think I should do? Yeah, what do you think my skill is? Like, I want to do something else with my life. Like, kuch idea dena. Like, try and brainstorming with them. Try and sitting down with them and seeing how you could achieve your goals and dreams. I'm sure your friends would love to help you. And if you have that support system, there's nothing like it, dude. Like, honestly, you just hear them out, hear their perspective, grasp whatever they have to say, and go back into your shell, into your room, and start brainstorming and thinking about what is it that you would also like to do. Look, ultimately, I can only give you advice. I can be like, do this, 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 ABC, this is what you have to do, follow it, do this. But if you don't actually take action and, you know, actually do it, you're not gonna get anywhere, okay? I can just be your virtual companion. I can even meet you and give you all the advice that I possibly could. But if you're not going to fix your life that needs fixing, then you're gonna be in deep trouble, okay? So fix your life. If you need to change your path, do it, okay? And I really need you to understand the gravity of this, okay? Because it is, once you find that sweet spot, once you find the what is it that you need to do, your life is gonna take a turn for the better, okay? Your relationships are gonna improve, you are gonna improve, like, you're just gonna be happy and fulfilled, okay? So just listening to me is not gonna pay your bills. Okay, so don't just listen to me and then feel good and then let it go the upcoming week. I want you to start taking action, okay? That's what's gonna pay your bills. That's what's gonna make you happy. So fix it, okay? Just make that decision, turn your life around, and start thinking about what you need to do with your life. Now, I know what most of us are afraid of. We are afraid of failing, right? Whatever happened, you failed. And then your parents come back and were like, I told you so. Like, you're afraid of that, right? You're afraid of your parents telling you, maine bola tha, lekin phir bhi tune kiya. That's why most of us don't take that step. That's why we're mostly scared, because we're afraid of judgment. We're afraid of people's opinions. We're afraid of failing at whatever age we are at. And we don't want to take that step. Listen, babes, I know it's easier said than done. I understand that. I know that it's much more difficult when you have no one supporting you, when your parents are not supporting you, your father is against you, your brother is against you. I cannot imagine the environment you're around when you have no support, because support is everything. Even if you have one person who believes in you, one, it can be your best friend, it can be your sibling, your father, mother, one person who's standing behind you and is like, go beta, I got your back, just go live your dreams. Your life will change. Okay, so parents watching me, please, please have it in your heart to support your daughter, to support your son. Like, give them a chance to live their dreams, okay? Like, please. It's a request with, like, both of my hands, because you have no idea what your kid is capable of. And once they start living their truth and once they start living their dreams, your life is about to change. So please, I request you to just trust them, trust in their abilities, and be there with them when they fail. Let me tell you one thing about failure, is that you will never go empty-handed. Okay, and now you're puzzled, like, what if I fail, I walk off with nothing, I lost my money, I lost my job, like, how does it help me, how does it serve me? If you went ahead and, you know, gave a shot at your dreams and you succeeded, amazing, at least you gave it a shot and now you're successful at it. If you don't and if you fail, you grow from it. You're taking life lessons that you would have never learned if you had succeeded. Now, let me give you my example, okay? If I hadn't failed multiple times in my life, I would not be here today, because I would not have learned the lessons I did when I failed. So growth is the most important thing. It's the most amazing thing that can ever happen to you. Okay, if you fail in your exam and you're petrified, like you have failed your board exams and you have to repeat the year, dude, you will have the best year ever after that, because you know where you went wrong, you know that this is what you did and this is what you should not have done, and it'll teach you something. Try and find meaning in failure. Now, if I hadn't failed in my pageant life, if I hadn't gotten rejected on 1,000 auditions, if I hadn't completely failed at my modeling career, I would not be here today. Okay, so taking my pageant story, like, I really wanted to become also Miss India. I wanted to become Miss World and then Miss Universe, because I was very inspired by my mother, because she was a pageant winner back in the day in Dubai, and I wanted to live like she did. I wanted to be a beauty queen, and it comes from there, right? So I entered the pageant when I was 18. I was so nervous, I had stage fright, I was stuttering, I completely lost out there, even though I had everything going on for me. I won like Miss Congeniality, Miss Best Beautiful Body, Miss like Timeless Beauty. I won 4 subtitles, but I never won the main pageant. That's because there was something in me that didn't allow me to go ahead. I was afraid of audiences. I was afraid of speaking out. I was afraid of my stutter and what would people think of me. I was a nervous wreck. Okay, and so I went on to Miss Diva, like, which is a path, I think, for Miss Universe, I think. I went 3 times, okay? I went through the process 3 times, filled out the forms, did everything, walked in my bikini like 1,000 times in front of people. And it's, sorry, but can I tell you what I really, really, really feel about the pageant world, at least in today's times, not in the past. But not Miss India and Miss Universe is not what it was like 15 years ago, man. That was being a beauty queen. Now it's like, I just felt like it was demeaning. I don't know, I felt like really low self-esteem when I was on stage. I didn't feel good about myself. I felt like, why am I parading myself out in a bikini, and why am I waiting for acceptance of 3 men out there? Why am I waiting for their validation that my body is perfect? Why am I waiting for them to tell me that I'm pretty or that I'm intelligent, or like, it was horrible, okay? And I felt horrible on that stage. And it was no longer serving me. It was no longer making me happy. It was not fulfilling me. And so I failed. And I remember I came so close to being the top 10 to go into Miss India. But they didn't pick me for some stupid odd reason. And I went and I cried so bad. I remember picking my phone up and my hands were shaking. And I'm like, Mom, like, it didn't happen. I'm never doing this again. Like, I still remember how badly I was crying. And I was rejected. And I felt such low self-esteem. And I was like, why am I even doing this? I felt horrible, you guys. Like, I was at my lowest when I was in the pageant world. And I was like, I'm never going to make it. Like, I made it a point that I'm never going to come back to my Miss India auditions again, because I got rejected for 3 years and I don't want to do this ever again. I was really sad, okay? I was horribly sad. But as I went on, like, time heals everything, like, you know, I went ahead with life and I got so many modeling opportunities, and I gave it my best shot there even. But because of my height, like, I didn't push through, and I felt like it was really low income. So that was also not satisfying me, and I failed there as well. Then I gave multiple auditions for every TV commercial you could have possibly imagined. I've been through auditions sitting for hours outside the studio waiting with my portfolio to just have them test me for one movie, test me for one Colgate ad, for one anything, Yardley ad, Dove ad. I never got selected, man. I got rejected so many times that rejection just became like a part of my life. Being in the Bollywood industry or like trying to become an actor is full of rejections, okay? You have to build a thick skin and you have to know that you will be rejected and the doors will be shut on you 1,000 times. And I was not used to that, but I sort of developed a thick skin and I got used to it. I got used to being rejected so many times that I just started feeling shitty about myself. And I'm just like, why am I even doing this? It's not fulfilling me. I wanted to be an actor, but the path to be an actor, being an actor, was not helping me. And you have to realize that the process and the journey to achieving your dreams, you have to love. You have to start loving that process. You have to build a thick skin. You have to start enjoying the journey to the main goal that you have. And I was not enjoying the journey to my main goal. And so I realized that it's not worth it. It's not worth my hours that I'm putting in. It's not worth the rejection. It's not worth the auditions I'm giving just to become an actor. Like, I was not enjoying the process. When I found YouTube, I am enjoying the process. I am loving every second video I create. I am loving the process. I want to spread love and I want to spread kindness. I want to be a motivational speaker at some point in my life. I want to be on stages. Like, I have these goals written down and I know where I have to go. But am I hating the process? No, I am loving the process. There's no way I'm being rejected. I'm being celebrated. I'm being validated by all you guys in a good way. I am, you know, it's all amazing. And I realized that all the 4 years that I've been through in my career, I've just loved the process of my growth. And that is what has led me to where I am today. So make sure that whatever path you pick, you're enjoying the process. You are able to take the hit whenever that comes to you. Not every process is going to be as smooth. Okay, you're going to be rejected. You're going to be hit down by a lot of things and obstacles in your life. But make sure that you are loving it enough to get up once again and go ahead with the process. Okay, so that's one thing I really like to tell you, is enjoy the process, because it's very important to where you're going to be. You don't want to be pushed down. You don't want low self-esteem like I had. Just make sure whatever path you choose, you are loving the process. Now, I get a lot of this as well, like, Miles, my parents don't support me, they are pushing me to be this, they're pushing me to be an engineer, I don't want to do this, I do not want to be a lawyer, but they are just pushing me into the school, they're making me be a chef, like, I don't want to do this, and I'm doing this just to make them happy, I'm doing this just because they're my parents. How do I say no to them? They're my parents. Like, firstly, I'm so sorry that you have to go through that. Like, I don't know what that means, because I've had the most amazing, supporting, kind parents ever. Okay, so I'm blessed in that sense that everyone that I have chosen to be around have been supporting and nothing less than that. And that is incredible for your growth, okay? And like I said, if you have one person that supports you, that is all you will ever need. And if you do not even have that one person, you have you. And that is all you will ever need. You are all you will ever need. And if you have enough courage and the will to push through and live your dreams, that is all you will ever need, okay? Do not live to please people. I told you that in the first video as well. Do not live to please your relatives, your office people or your parents. And it's very difficult, I know, because they're your parents and some parents are so amazing, but then they put their dreams on us and they force you to go here and there, that it feels really bad to even reject it or put them down, because you respect them because they're your parents, and I get that. A lot of your relatives, a lot of your family who are like just constantly on top of you and constantly are like, you gotta do this, tumhein jana hi padega. They put you in 1,000 tuitions, they put you in so many things, and you're just like so tired of life and you're so dejected and you feel like you're worn down, but you're doing it for them. I want to say that a lot of people who don't allow you to live your dreams are just scared, okay? They're scared because you are changing for the better. And they're not used to that, okay? A lot of them didn't live their dreams. They lived their parents' dreams. And so that's the life they know, and they're projecting it on you. You know what I'm saying? So it's just coming through earlier family ties, which are not your fault or your parents' fault. It's just something that they know. That's the only thing they know. And they're scared that you are changing for the better, you are growing, you're living your dreams. It is scaring them, and that's why sometimes they don't want you to live that life, because they didn't get to live their dreams. So they're pulling you down and they're pushing you in the path that they just know is right, okay? So it's no one's fault here, because it all comes from previous family ties. That's all you know, is what you've learned from your parents, right? So I'm not blaming parents, but I'm trying to just help you understand that it's okay to break the tie, it's okay to break that line and be a trailblazer. okay? It's okay to be a trailblazer and blaze a trail and form another direction. And it's okay not to be a doctor, lawyer, engineer. For once, just be like, no, mom, I'm gonna do what I want. What are they gonna do to you guys? Are they gonna kick you out of your house? Are they gonna stop loving you? If they do that, you might as well leave on your own. Like, I don't even know what it is like to live with parents who disown you and abuse you and like hit you for just voicing your opinions and living your dreams. I don't know what it is like to live in a situation like that, but all you gotta do is do whatever you can, be an adult and leave that environment, because it's not serving you, man. Even if they're your parents, they're not helping you grow. I heard Rachel Hollis say this, and she's like, what they want for your life cannot be more powerful than what you want in your life. It cannot top it, okay? Because again, you are living your life. It is your life at the end of the day. Picture this, okay? I was thinking about it the other day. You have lived the life that your parents wanted you to live, okay? You've done everything you can, and you've become, you know, you've joined the family business, and it is where you're at, and your parents are now like 75 years old, 80 years old, and life has caught on to them, and they've passed away, okay? And you are around like 45, 50, and you were doing what they wanted you to do. You were building the family business, but you hated it every second. But now they have passed away, and they left their burdens and their dreams on you, and you are stuck in this life, and you didn't even deserve it. You didn't even want to live that life in the first place. Tell me, is that fair? That is so not fair. Like, I don't understand how that is okay to do. I know these are difficult topics to talk about. I know it's gonna hurt a lot of people and it's gonna hit the wrong spots for some people, but I have to say it as it is, okay? I'm gonna be talking about difficult things on my channel, and if it's difficult to hear, then it might be the truth. You know what I'm saying? Like, no one's gonna tell you that, but I'm gonna tell you this. And I feel like, is it fair that you are living your parents' dreams? Is it fair that you are going to live the rest of your life based on someone else's opinion and someone else's decisions? Or would you rather have them be angry with you for some time? Would you rather have them not talk to you for some time? But, you know, change your path and become a trailblazer and do your own thing and live your dream and be successful at it. And then you mend your ways with them, you know, then you just... If once they start seeing you happy, once they start seeing you at the prime of your life and you just smiling and being the happiest possible person you can be, I think they're gonna start changing their ideas. They're gonna be like, okay, fine, this is what she meant. It's okay, man. Sometimes we have to take really difficult decisions. Sometimes we have to choose paths that hurt us deep within. But I feel like they're going to get it at some point. And if they don't, I feel really sorry, but it's something you have to do. Spending your entire life on someone else's dreams is a waste of your life, because you haven't even explored opportunities. You get one life, man. You get one damn life, and you want to live someone else's dreams? You want to be someone you were never meant to be in the first place? I don't think so. I don't think that's even fair to ask your child to do that. But I don't know. I hope it really puts you in this thinking spot where you really start analyzing what you've thought for your kids, or you really start analyzing what you thought for your own life. I'm talking to parents and to kids both here. But yeah, I really, really want you to consider this and like really think about it. You have today. Today's the time you have. I want you to spin your life around and think what it is that you want to do for your life. And I want you to start doing it today. Okay, so that's why it's like school, college, you go here, this is where you'll study, this is where you'll go abroad, this is when you'll come back and you'll start your life and you'll get married. Like, our parents plan our lives out for us before we have the chance to even say anything about our own lives. We don't get to take our own decisions. Not in all places, but in most cultures, that's the truth, right? Our parents just decide what is good for us, and that's that. We don't get to take the time out to make our mistakes and learn from it and grow from it. And I know parents are only doing what's best for us. I know it. I'm not a parent, but I get where you're at. But I feel like I wish you would just start giving your parents giving your kids the opportunity to start figuring, you know, what they want to do in life. And that is really, really something that I cannot even fathom, because I know so many of us go through that. Like, we're just put in places that our parents want us to be, and that's what our life is, and that's what it becomes. Now, a lot of parents and a lot of our relatives who talk a lot, you know who I'm talking about, you're thinking of that very relative, right? I know, who just has a lot to say about your life and a lot about your career and has things to point out every single time you do things that you do, they're like literally afraid of you changing. Like they're so scared because you are standing up for yourself, you are believing in yourself because they never did. They are petrified of you bettering yourself, okay? They are petrified of you succeeding. And that's what you want to exactly do. I know not everyone is fortunate enough to have supportive parents, but dude, like if they don't, it is not your problem. I'm sorry, this is the harsh reality, but it is just something they'll have to live with. If your husband doesn't approve of you working, if your boyfriend, if your girlfriend doesn't understand your dreams, I want you to sit them down and make them understand that your dreams are important and valid as well. It's as important as their dreams too. If your husband is a CEO and you want to start a small business, your dreams are as valid as the CEO right here. So he is supposed to give you the tools to become an amazing entrepreneur, to help you in whatever you can. You'll have to contribute in each other's successes, okay? That's what it is, being around people and the friends that you have and siblings and your parents, and they need to contribute. Otherwise, it's going to be tougher, but not impossible. Not impossible, okay? It's okay with people not being happy with you, not liking you, not talking to you. Shun everything out. Shun the noise and do what you have to until you are at a place where you're happy, okay? You have to live with yourself for the rest of your life, not with the 30 other people that are talking about you behind your back, okay? So choose what's right for your life and go with it, because honey, trust me, there is no happiness like that. Okay, listen to this. I heard Rachel Hollis say this and it blew my mind. It's so amazing, okay? Imagine Elon Musk, Jeff Bezos, the founder of Amazon, like Deepika Padukone, Ranveer Singh, Ranbir Kapoor, whoever your favorite successful person is, and take a lot of unfortunate people, okay, and that are not doing very well right now. It's a vast difference, right? But one thing we all have in common, can you guess it? It's time. Like all of us get 24 hours in the day. The billionaire as well as the poor person, we all get 24 hours. It blew my mind because I'm like, yeah, we both have 24 hours in the day. And that is such a powerful thing to have, because we can get our lives up to here only if we put in double the amount of efforts. Now, again, it depends on circumstances, on the support you have, the money. I get it. There are a lot of factors that contribute to your success. But you know what I'm trying to say? Like, we all get 24 hours. And if you just put in the hours, man, if you just put in that hard work, and if you decide today that you want to change your life, you can change your life. Now, I'm thinking about my grandmother while I'm saying this, and she's amazing. And she's had a really, really tough life, okay? My grandmother is someone that I really love, and she has lived such a difficult life, and she's around like 70s, I don't know how, but late 70s right now. And I don't talk to her a lot because she lives far away from me, but we do like WhatsApp each other every single day, like 1-2 sentences. But she holds a very, very, very special place in my heart. She's lived such a tough life, and she was an amazing designer, okay? She had her own like boutique where she used to tailor her own like salwar kameezes and stuff, and such beautiful ones. And I still remember going to her shop, and she used to tailor stuff, and you know, and she could have been like the most amazing like fashion designer. And she gave up her dreams because she got married, and she had to take care of her husband, and she had to take care of everyone else around her, and she just gave up that life. She shut shop, and now she is in that one room, and I'm thinking about her, and all she does is regret, right? All she does is look back on her life, and she keeps telling me, Miles, I wish I had done this. Miles, I wish I had married a little later. Miles, I wish. All of that is coming now, and I'm like, Dadi, now what can you do? Now she's come of age, and she doesn't have that energy that she used to, you know. She's in her late 70s, and all she does is regrets. She has so many regrets, like she wishes she would have done things differently, but other people controlled her life, like, you know. And it just bothers me so much, and I wish I knew that earlier, you know. But this is what I'm trying to say, like, if I had to give a do-over to someone to live their life all over again, it would be my grandmom, man. She deserves to live her life from scratch and start her life completely from the beginning, because I see what she lost out on, and I see she lost herself. And for me, like, I did not want to become that person. And in a way, she kind of like sparked something in me too, like, you know, she taught me, like, you gotta make better choices. Like, whenever she used to come visit, she used to be like, dude, take your time, get married whenever. She's the most forward-thinking grandmother ever, okay? My daddy is like, you know, take your time, don't even think about getting married until you're settled, be financially secure, make sure you're taking care of yourself first, make sure you put yourself first. I wish I had done that, beta. I didn't do it, and now I regret it. And you know, it's sort of like, I think that contributed to where my mindset when I was younger, you know, because she kept feeding me with things that I needed to know. Most grandmothers are like, please make me a great grandmother. I want to see your kid before I... My grandmother was not like that, is not like that. She's alive. She's always like, you know, take your time, live your dream, be independent, get married later, have kids whenever you want or don't. Like, she's so forward thinking. It's because of all the lessons life has taught her that she didn't get to do. She hopes and wishes that I don't do the same mistakes. And I don't know, I thought of the story because I wanted you to know that I don't want you to be in that position where you have to regret your life. Have you ever wondered, like, the only people that judge you are people that are insecure? And have you wondered that the people that judge you and have opinions about you and have something to say all the time are the people that are usually insecure about their own lives? Because most people that have not achieved a lot or are scared of living their dreams have something to say about other people's dreams, and that's all the time. You will rarely find successful people judging your lives, like, because they've been through it, they've put in the hours, they have done the work that it takes, they know the struggle that it takes to get where they are. So they will never judge you. Like, people like that rarely ever judge you. It's only the people who are hidden in their homes, who don't do anything with their lives. Why should we care about people like that? Like, why should we give that opinion so much weight? Okay, an opinion only becomes a reality when you give it that much attention and that much weight. So let's not do that starting today. You have to be obsessed with your dreams, my girls. You have to be absolutely, it has to be your life's mission. Your life should be about living, breathing, and just like doing everything you can possibly to grow and achieve your goals. And do not take no for an answer. Like, just make that your statement. Like, do not take no for an answer. No matter who says it to you, no, you can't become this, no, you can't do this. And like I said earlier, you need to enjoy the process. Like, no matter what setbacks you have, no matter what obstacles come your way while you're on the journey of achieving your goal, you need to learn how to take care of yourself. And that's where self-love comes in, wherein then you will know how to take care of yourself, how to handle yourself and enjoy the process and not give up when you're on your journey of achieving your goals. And I feel like that is really, really important to have. No amount of money is gonna make you happy if you're not happy in your current situation right now. I've said it in my earlier video as well, like, even if you become a size zero, I don't know if you're gonna achieve like happiness because you did not take the time to train yourself to be happy when you were overweight. So try and be happy exactly where you are right now. Try and manifest joy in your life. Try and find meaning in failure. Try and look for the positive things when it's the darkest of times. And I promise you, like, you will come out of it much better. You will grow, you will learn, and it's only going to be fruitful in your life. All right, so we're almost done. I have an activity for you, okay? Starting tomorrow, you are going to wake up 1 hour early. That is your activity for this week and for the rest of your life, if you can. But we're gonna start slow and we're gonna start this week, okay? And I'll tell you why. Because a lot of us, and I've come across a lot of people saying, Miles, I don't have time to do this. I don't have time to go to the gym. I'm completely blocked. I work day and night. My office is from 9 to 9 and I'm exhausted. I cannot make dinner and go and work out. And remember the point I told you, we all have the same amount of time that is given to us. How we manage our time and prioritize our time is what matters. Okay, so make sure you are utilizing that time. And that's why I want you to wake up an hour early. If you think that you are not able to give yourself enough time in the day with taking care of your family and doing several other things, I want you to wake up early and give yourself that 1 hour. Metro ka kaam chal raha hai bahar, so it's okay. There's a lot of noise outside. If you're waking up at 9, I want you to wake up at 8. And I want you to do whatever it is you can to get a step ahead in your process. So yeah, I'm hoping you guys take this seriously and you're writing this down somewhere because it's going to be beneficial only for you. It's serving you. I'm not going to get anything out of it. I'm just telling you, but you have to take control and you are to do this activity daily, every day in your life, and you'll see the progress. If you want to lose weight and if you don't have time to go to the gym, you got to manage your time and wake up at 5 o'clock if you have to. When the sun is down, you are developing yourself, okay? It's still not risen, but other people in your circle are sleeping, they're snoring away, and you are one step ahead in your goal. Think about it like that. You are moving faster, you are growing, you're learning, and you're giving yourself so much time and growth and energy and positivity way before the day even begins that, like, you know, you're going to be ahead of everyone. You're going to be in a better place. Few things you have to do in order to, like, find your goals, find your dreams, sort of your path. A, spend a lot of time with yourself, and I've said that in the first video. I want you to get to know yourself, spend a lot of time, okay? So that correlates with getting up early in the morning. That's sort of like, you know, the same thing. Number two is find your why. Okay, I really, really need you guys to find your reason, your purpose for waking up in the morning. Like, why do you get up in the morning? I wake up in the morning to make this video, to create content, to do my beauty tutorials. That fuels my fire and that is my reason, and that's why I wake up every single day. What is your reason? Okay, I need you to focus on your why. Number three is spend enough time around the people you want to be like. And what I mean by that is that, okay, take for example, you want to be the next Shamak Davar. Shamak Davar is a great, great dancer here in India, if anyone's not in India. So if you want to be under Shamak Davar, you need to literally be his shadow. So how do you get there? Okay, A, you gotta like take his workshops, you gotta start at his basic level dance classes, then move up the ladder, become a trainer in one of his classes, one of his batches, then you sort of start attending shows with him, then you start doing awards with him, then you dance really closely with him, and then you can start like open your own academy at some point. But if you want to become Shamak Davar, you need to learn his life, you need to become obsessed with the way he lives his life. And I don't mean stalking, I mean like you need to know what he does, what are the hours he puts in, does he wake up 6 o'clock in the morning, work out, dance all day. Like, if he does that, are you willing to put in the hours to become a Shamak Davar? Are you willing to put in the hours to become a CEO, a billionaire, a monk, whatever your goal is to be? You need to be around those people. You need to network in that circle, okay? You can't be with business people if you want to be an actor. It's not going to serve you, okay? If you want to be an actor, you got to start at the beginning. You got to take test shots. You got to take Hindi classes. You got to take Urdu classes. Then you got to go to auditions, try for TV commercials, then assist someone in a movie, assist in the TVC. You got to climb up the ladder and be in the same network. And this will help you realize whether you really want to become that person or you don't. And this takes me to the next point, which is expose yourself to all different avenues. I feel like dip your toes in every avenue you can if you really are confused and you cannot find what you need to do. Okay, try taking salsa dance classes, try taking jazz, try taking a singing lesson, try taking a business workshop, a yoga session, try taking a cooking class. See where your pull is. You will recognize where your body is getting pulled to, your soul. You might find business class really boring and you're like, bro, I don't know, like this is cool and stuff, but I'm not, this is not my jam. When you go to singing class, you're like, it's fun, but I don't want to wake up to come here every morning. Then when you go to your salsa classes, you're like, dude, this is really fun and I can't wait for the next class. You have found your rhythm. You have found a place where you're being pulled at the most. Okay, so try putting your hands in different pots and see where you're getting pulled at. Maybe that could be a step where you can find your path. So expose yourself to things. Don't be stuck to, I'm gonna try jewelry business just because my father did it. You don't have to do that. You can dip in every way you can and see what other people are doing and find your pull. Maybe you'll find something that excites you. If you don't try it, if you don't expose yourself to other avenues, how are you gonna know what you're good at? And you'll actually see, like, is this what I really want to do for the rest of my life? You might not like it. You might like the result of being rich and being a famous star, but you might not like the hours that you have to put in to become that star. So then you will recognize that, okay, this is not what I want to do, then it's not going to help me, I'm not going to enjoy the process of becoming a star. So you can switch paths and turn it into something else and see if that's the process you like. But unless you expose yourself to the people that you want to be like, you're not going to know their life, you're not going to know what it takes to become a star, what it takes to become a billionaire, what it takes to become a CEO. You need to be in that circle and you need to study their lives to see if that's the life you want to live. The next point is go back to your childhood and try and find something that fueled your fire, whether it was pottery, whether it was art, whether it was painting, whether it was exercise, what fueled your fire, and try and go back to it and see whether it fuels you again. I know a lot of us are thinking, Miles, only if I had a father to support me, only if I had money, only if I was living in a bigger house, if I was living in Bombay. Like, these are things that we find excuses to stop the process. But I want you to stop focusing on the negative energy and I want you to find an energy and an emotion that is bigger than the negative one. And like Rachel says, I want you to find tactical solutions. I want you to find something that is instant. Okay, if it is, it's praying for me. Like, I love praying. It puts me in a good mood. Or it's putting on the camera and filming. That puts me in a great mood. Something that pulls you out of your sad, sulky state. Something that is not allowing you to dwell and wallow in your sadness. Okay, find solutions that help you tackle that. if it's running, going for a run, going for an exercise, hitting the gym, like jumping up 5-6 times, talking to your friends, like it could be whatever. You need to get on it right away so that you push that negative feeling aside and you get on to a positive sign. I didn't have anything. I started with the phone, and you can do as well, okay? So stop looking at if and start Googling, start finding answers online. Everything is available online. So in today's world with so much information out there, ignorance is a choice, okay? And if you choose not to go do your research, if you choose to just like sulk and wallow and see that, okay, there's no one to help me, then that is your choice, okay? You have decided to do that. But we have a lot of information out there. We can start our channel. We can do whatever we can with the help of our fingertips. Research something that you can't. If you don't have friends and family, open the internet and start looking up things that you want to do. Find a way to start a business. Find a way to start a channel. There are things you can do. No one's gonna sit and hold your hand and pull you through your journey. You gotta pick yourself up. So that's it. Those are my things to do for the upcoming week and for the rest of your life, if you can and you should. I really hope that I helped you in some way or the other. Even if I got you to thinking, and if I flipped a switch that got you thinking about your dreams and goals in today's video, I'm so happy, because that's all I wanted. I just wanted you to stop lazing around, and I wanted you to pick yourself up and take control of your life and make your decision and plan your life out, because it's so important. We don't want to live in a life with no purpose and no passion and no goals and dreams. What is that kind of life, man? Do you want to live that boring, dull life? I don't think so. I think you want to live a life fueled with fire, passion, and something that is your ikigai, your reason for being, something that you wake up for every single morning. Okay, so thank you so much for watching. I love you so much. Please share this with your family and friends who are stuck, who are lost, who don't know what exactly to do, if it helped you. And comment down below, and I will respond to as many comments as I can. Thank you so much for joining me. I love you from the bottom of my heart. The fact that you have listened to me for so long makes me know that you are interested on this journey of self-love, and you are motivated, and you want to grow and learn, and you value yourself. Big hugs to you. Mwah. I love you so much. Bye. Virtual hugs.